Now. the gift. And in this game, when the music plays, we're going to pass the gift. And when the music stops, we freeze, and that person unwraps one layer. Just one. All right? Here we go. Just one layer, remember? We're gonna unwrap the second layer. All right, boys and girls, what does it look like we have? If you said the Bible, you are correct. I wonder why we've got the Bible.
Did you guys enjoy the game?
Yeah. Yes.
Did you receive any gift during the game?
Yes.
No. Yeah.
Yes. What is the best gift you've ever received?
Pizza.
Socks.
My kids.
What do you think is the world's greatest gift?
The Bible.
A tree.
The Bible tells us that the greatest gift that God has given us. Do you know what that is?
I wonder what it is.
It can be found in John 3:16. Will you read that for us?
Yes. John 3:16 says, "For this is how God loved the world. He gave his one and only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life."
God loves us very much, and he wants us to be with him forever.
Did we enjoy the game, boys and girls? Hopefully you'll try it at home. We love you. We miss you.
You know, sometimes we don't get the gift that we want. But what I want to talk to you about today is about the absolute greatest gift ever. Do you know what that is? It's Jesus. Yes, Jesus was the greatest gift ever. Now, some of you are probably scratching your head and going, "Miss Brainy, how can a person be the greatest gift ever?" Well, let me explain. Jesus was a gift from God. God sent his son. In John chapter 3, it says that God loved the world so much that he gave his son. It's a gift. Jesus was a gift from God. You see, God loved his son, but the scripture says that God loved his son so much that he gave him to us as a gift. And it was a gift so that we could have eternal life. The greatest gift ever was a gift from God, his son, that it sounds strange, I know, but a person can be a gift. Jesus was that gift. And through his death, his burial, and his resurrection, we can have forgiveness. Yeah, that's the gift that we got through Jesus. The true gift of forgiveness that came through Jesus's death, burial, and resurrection. Now, think about this. Think about the fact of somebody coming to you with a gift, like what I have here. They bring you a gift, but instead of reaching out to receive it, you stand there with your arms down, not grabbing out for it, not receiving that. God knew that we were going to have issues, understanding how him, a perfect God, would love us messy sinners. But you know what? He made it as easy as A, B, C. He made it simple for us because he knew that we would try to mess it up. So first you have A. A means admit. We have to admit that we've messed up. How many of you have messed up? I know all of us have been there. And we have to admit that we've done something wrong. That's the first step. Then we have B, believe. We must believe that God is sent his son Jesus to live a perfect life and die on the cross to pay the price for all of those things that we messed up. So that's B. First you have A, admit, B, believe, and C, we have to choose. Kind of like grabbing out for that gift. We have to choose to accept that gift of forgiveness and follow Jesus. We have to choose to follow him. You know, maybe we have never known about the greatest gift. Maybe this is the first time that you have heard about Jesus being the greatest gift and loving you even though you've messed up. Maybe you're choosing now to accept. Maybe your hands are out now to accept that gift of Jesus. Remember, we make it hard, but God made it as easy as A, B, C. Admit, believe, and choose. I want to pray with you right now. Even if you have already prayed, even if you've already had your hand out and you've already received that gift of Jesus, you can still pray with us. So everybody bow your head, close your eyes, and pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, God, I thank you so much for your gift, the greatest gift of your Son being sent to us, given to us as a gift. Lord, I pray that for those of us who have decided to take the steps of A, B, C, that we accept, that we admit that we're messed up. God, we have sinned. We have messed up. B, we believe. We believe that Jesus came to die on the cross for us, for our messy selves. And see, Lord, we are choosing. We are choosing to follow you. We are choosing to receive the greatest gift ever. And we ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. And if that's your first time of praying that, please let me know in the comments. But you know what? I believe we have a really cool object lesson that goes right along with this. Stay tuned, watch, because this is going to be pretty cool. Bye, guys.
Hey, Worship Center kids, it's Miss Jennifer. I haven't seen you guys in a really long time, and I'm looking forward to talking to you today. You guys have always been really good about helping me figure out problems when I was teaching back there in church, and so I thought I'd come to you today and kind of show you some stuff I've gotten. I'm a little confused, and I thought that maybe you could help me figure some stuff out. You know, we just got finished with Christmas, and we've all gotten some really lovely gifts. And one of the gifts that I got was kind of confusing to me. Somebody brought me this lovely cake plate. I got this beautiful cake plate, and on it, there are some ingredients. Now, I did a cookie and recipe exchange this year. So I have a recipe tree back here. Someone sent me a recipe for some cookies and they sent me these ingredients for cookies. I've got some milk and a little container that has salt on one side and sugar on another. I'm really not sure which one is which and I'm not sure what to do with it. I've got a stick of butter, a couple of eggs, and then I've got some flour and some chocolate chips. And I have my recipe, and these things are all here together, and I'm still waiting on it to become a cookie. Like, it tells me the ingredients. I have the ingredients, and they're all right here. And maybe I need to figure out which one is salt and which one is sugar. So let me see. Well, I can taste and see that that's sugar. That's good. Let's see. Ooh, yeah, salt. But I know salt is important in making cookies and baking things. But I've just been sitting here looking at these, and I covered them up for a while, and I left them out on my table. When I came back, they still weren't cookies. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I have the ingredients, and I have the recipe. There was another gift that was given that's kind of the same way, and it confuses a lot of people, so I wanted to help you understand that. And maybe if I explain that, maybe we can kind of think about the cookies and figure out what's going wrong. There was a gift that was given many, many years ago. I'm going to turn around here so you can see. And this gift was in written form in many ways and in many languages. And I got this as a gift. This is my very favorite Bible. It has a lot of words in it. It has a lot of really pretty pictures. There's maps and things in here. And it tells about things that happened a long time ago and things that happened before Jesus was here and things that happened after Jesus came. So I keep this on my bookshelf and I like to look at it. It's neat when you look at it from here. And this one's called Archaeological Bible. So it's about really old stuff and why stuff was important a long time ago. I've read it, and it's neat. It has a lot of cool things, a lot of cool stories in it. And sometimes people do that. They get a Bible for a gift, and they read it, but they really don't understand what's in it. They just kind of look through it a little bit, and then they'll put it away on their bookshelf or on their bedside table. But what I want to talk to you about today is salvation. And we know that salvation is when we ask Jesus into our hearts and he comes and lives with us in our heart. Well, there's something that's important that I think that a lot of people don't understand. You see, there was a beautiful, wonderful gift that was given to us many, many years ago, and we just celebrated it. And what that gift is the gift of Jesus's birth. And there's a little baby Jesus in there. And he came wrapped in a gift that didn't seem really very well put together. He came wrapped in swaddling clothes. He was put in a manger. He was surrounded by animals in a stinky place. And he just laid there. Now, a lot of people didn't understand why that was a gift. Why was this baby born in a stinky old barn a gift? Well, you see, salvation, while a lot of people think that salvation is something, it's actually an action. And you guys learn in school sometimes about action words. Salvation is an action word. We ask God to come and live in our heart. We ask Jesus to help us to live our life. And just like my cookies, if I don't read the recipe and follow the recipe, all it is some ingredients. It's a nice gift that somebody left, but all of my ingredients will be wasted if I don't do anything to use them. I have to take the action to mix the things together and to bake them in the oven. And when I do that, and I take the action that's required, then what I get in the end is a lovely baked cookie. But I have to make the choice to do the action. I have to ask Jesus into my heart. I have to take my other really awesome gift that I got, my Bible. And this is like the recipe for cookies. This gives us the recipe for our whole lives. Any question that you would have, any problem that you would have, and anything that you ever need to know is right in this book. Jesus came to earth as a baby wrapped in a very plain and unusual package. And what he brought us when he came was the gift of salvation. Now, if someone were to have given me this gift and I didn't do anything with it at all, and I just laid it on my table and I never, ever read it, then it's of no use to me. It's just a thing that lays on a table. Just like salvation. If you're given the gift of salvation, and every single one of us are given the gift of salvation, God gives it to every one of us. And all we have to do is to accept it from him, to take it from him. And the only thing you have to do that is to say, Jesus, I accept salvation. I ask you to forgive me of all my sins. And I want to live in a way that makes you very happy. And what happens when we do that is he comes and he lives with us and he helps us and he gives us the Bible, which is our recipe for exactly what we need to do in our lives. Anything that you should need or ask, he's here to give it to you. So don't ever think that salvation is just a gift that Jesus gives automatically. You have to take the effort to ask him into your heart. But after that, it's done. I mean, that's not hard. So if you want to give your heart to Jesus and you want to live in a way that makes Jesus happy, all you have to do is ask him. And if you have any questions about this object lesson, or you have any questions at all about how easy it is to ask Jesus in your heart or even any of your family members, please don't hesitate to contact someone at the church, Miss Brandy or myself, or anyone at all, Pastor Jason, Pastor Melissa, or any of the host of people that are more than willing to help you understand what it is that Jesus wants to give you. Feel free to give them a call or contact them on email. I've loved spending time with you today. And see, even though we can't talk to each other, I know that you were giving me the answers and I could feel it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pray for all of you also, that you can feel the answers of what Jesus has for you. Bye.